When the case looks like this, you know, it's got to be something pretty crazy. Check this out.
It's a little stinky, but I'm pretty sure it's the original box. Found under a bed. Check that out.
Supro. Yeah, she is a little stinky. I didn't think it was when it showed up, but I can smell it now, so I'm going to have to extract the case from my house. Can't have that in here, because this shit just grows.
Okay. Let's find out what a Supro's all about. It does make sound. Let's turn everything up. Sure what the switches do. On off for each pickup? Is that? That seems about it does. What? That's that guy. Off off. On off. Okay, so that's what those do. There's this little red doohickey though, and there's a opening on the back as well. I had a little message back and forth with my good friend Scully, who is a Supro freak, right? He loves these things. This is a, I guess what they call it, rezo glass, some type of fiberglass, and this is all hollow. And then these screws hold the two pieces together, and then there's this gasket in between, right? All the shit that's on the gasket, that's off that case that stinks, and it can't, once I clean it, it really shouldn't go back in that case. But see how the two different materials took the paint differently? The rezo glass never faded, but the wood neck did. And we don't think it has a truss rod, but I do want to check. So I'm going to get the strings off it, and we're going to have a little peek inside. Just because I'm very curious. I don't have any. Does it do anything when you play? And it doesn't, it's not like a switch that stays flipped. You hold it. I can't see that it does anything. And, you know, we want to clean that up too, right? All right, let's begin.
And no, it does not have a truss rod, but it had this big ugly piece of cardboard in there for a shim, but I don't know why you'd need that, because it has this thing that lets you adjust the neck angle. Right? And then those thread in. I don't have a lot of faith in that. Because this isn't a screw, it's a bolt, and that looks to me like just threads cut into wood. All right, well, let's see what happens. But you see, that's what that guy does, the middle one. Those two hold the neck on. Let's look under here.
Okay, so you don't really get inside one of these without a bit of a fight. That's what it looks like. It is really just, it's a fiberglass shell. I'm going to just put aside for a minute. But apparently that little thing in the back, that's where a battery went. I have no idea what voltage it would be. It looks like maybe a C size battery. It's not a 9 volt. And when you hit that little switch, it actuates something. It looks like there's been some corn cob fabricating here. I don't think they used electrical tape. What the hell does it do? Oh, don't lose that, David. It's just a little block of wood and that little switch. And I'm looking for circuitry, which is it hidden in this little block of wood? Well, I will put a battery to it. It does tell me what's plus. Like I said, it looks like maybe a C size. It's not a D. Okay, well, I'm gonna just put the, now that I see what's inside here, I'm just a little curious about that connection, why it's got that on there. Oh, that's why it's got that on there. It's been broken. That resistor is supposed to go across there, I think. Can I see where it used to be? Or is that just the lead that comes through? Well, that won't work unless we figure out what this circuit is. And that might be another day. Anyway, we'll just put that back on there. Did it have gone there? I'll just look in here. When you flip that switch, it connects the battery to whatever is hidden in that little block of wood, which we don't know. Oh, I see. It's some sort of little microphone of some type shoved into a little block of wood. Wow. Like a little pickup of some type. Just really looking carefully as to where that resistor used to want to live. Interesting. More research is needed, obviously. So there's another strike against this, even if I find out where the hell that resistor is supposed to be connected. Did it belong on the end of the battery box? Is that where it went? Like right there, possibly. You know, there's another strike against it here, though. And to fix that, I really got to release things, because the little reed switch that little red thing operates isn't making contact that I can see. It needs to be bent over. Maybe I can get that from here. I'm going to try reattaching that to the end of the, that would make sense. It would be part of the circuit that powers this little gizmo. Yeah, let's do that. Okay. I reattached the resistor, but the switch, she sometime works, sometime I know. So, see if I can remedy that without having to take too much apart. Well, unfortunately, folks, there's not a lot. Can I actually remove that? Maybe I can remove that. Let's see what happens. No, I don't want to remove that. I got something better for this. Well, try cleaning those little contacts in there. That's going to help too. Today's recipe will be deoxit D-series D100L. Very expensive stuff. And very, very effective, especially for this type of switch. But a small bottle of this, I've had this about 5 years, I think. What happened? I think we won. Okay, I'm going to piece this back together, guys, now that I think I solved what probably didn't work. It may not work anymore at all, but we'll find out. I think what probably happened is that somewhere down the line, that they didn't really leave much on that resistor lead, and it broke off, and maybe nobody cared or didn't have the ability to put it back together. And right now I am going to carefully put the back shell on this, and we're going to clean it up, put it back together, put some strings on it, and see if we can figure out if that actually makes a noise. Yeah, it looks like some sort of little condenser mic. hidden inside this little block of wood, but I'm gonna have to look up more and see if I can find it. I'll have to ask the Scully. Scully's very busy. He's on the road tuning guitars for Jeff Beck. Most of us still can't believe that, but we do because we know him and we love him and he is the best. All right. He's gonna be in town next week with Jeff Beck. I would really be hoping that I'm gonna get to see that. How do we do here? Look at that. I think I got the two halves together. Possibly. Yeah. Not bad at all, Davey. Not bad at all. Alright, let's button it up, clean it up, finish it up. Today's recipe for... Why is it my frickin'... You know, it's always something, right guys? Stupid things. Doesn't want to squirt. There we go. Today's recipe is good old Ronsonol. And that's cleaning all that fucking black shit off that cool rubber extrusion. Maybe a little more aggressive in some spots, but that all that crap is from that case. That's why it can't go back in that case.
Okay. This is also kind of interesting how the neck and the pocket are cut at an angle like that, so it wedges itself in. But what I'm doing way down here, guys, remember I showed you that little thing that lets you tilt the neck. Well, I just want to see. Let's drop the bridge. It's got a million extra adjustment screws on it, which I don't think it needs. I'll lose two of those. Make sure. No, it does need those. That one's frozen. Gee whiz, it's always something. So we'll say the bridge is in its lowest position. I just want to make sure I'm holding the neck in where it needs to belong. It's not mission critical, but it's going to make a bit of a difference. And if I bring the straight edge across there, we're going to need to tip this up a bit, but not as much as that big piece of cardboard that was in there before. Getting a set of these. And so I realized why they put those extra thumb wheels on there, because the original ones were frozen solid, so they couldn't get them off and they just put new ones on top. So I got rid of those. They're gone. Strings, let's do it. So I had to fool around a little bit with that tilt function that obviously the other guys didn't have a clue how it worked or what it did. And I pretty much got the string height right where a Gibson would be. Yeah. Do they all work? I'm sure there is a way to adjust the pickup heights on this, and I don't know what's going on here. I might have to take the back off of this one more time. But now that I've learned, you can do that with all the strings and everything on it. That's how you get to everything. So I might just do that and see what's going on with that pickup. Or no, that's the pick. That one's mounted in the pick guard. This one's mounted in the Well, I want to find a battery. We'll just make sure it makes noise, right? Yeah, everything else works. And this really needs new tuners. Mainly because this will make you laugh. This one's backwards. It's off a guitar for the opposite side. Yeah. Okay, let's find a battery that fits in that hole and see what this thing does, if anything. Well, of course I have nothing. So I had to fabric cobble a power source. I don't think it does shit, boys. I'm gonna stop there. That's where I'm stopping. Just want to thank everybody for hanging out with me. And, you know, I'll look up some more information about this, see if I can figure out if this actually works or not. Apparently not. Yeah, thanks to everybody. Kind of a weird tone on this guy. There's no power to it anyways, I took it off. Yeah, thanks to everybody. Thanks for all the support, to my patrons, everybody who's bought a sticker, a Penny Black CD. There are still more below. The Facebook group, if you really want to get crazy. And other than that, be good to each other. Cheers, folks.